Ravenia. Rebellion. Rebellion. Ravenia. Lumos. Revelio. Rebellion. Ravenclaw. Rebellion. Ravenclaw. Lumos.
Behave, damn you.
Ravenclaw. Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Wingardium Leviosa.
Just let me know if there's something in particular you're looking for. Let's look at what we have, shall we? Let me know if there's anything else I can do to help.
Beetle the Bard is a bit too hairy-hearted for my taste.
Revelio.
We have everything a young student might need when it comes to potions. Have a good look around.
Revelio. Have a look around. I'll be with you in just a minute. Rescuing the wee niffler from the dark wizards. Brave one you are. Revelio.
Revelio. Revelio.
Is it distinct lack of models?
Ah, it's always nice to see a familiar face. Oh.
Revelio.
You're back! Nice to see you again!
I'm certain Mr. Pratt will learn to appreciate his new surroundings at the Hog's Head. Was thinking of doing some redecorating myself before you stepped in.
Revelio. Ravenia. 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 Ravenia.
Can be just as dangerous as Crucio in the wrong hands. Or the right ones.
I've been a vampire worth knowing.
How does the Ministry decide which curses are unforgivable?
The tales of Beedle the Bard still ring true today.
The unforgivable curses weren't always outlawed.
You have to have conviction to use an unforgivable. Not everyone has that kind of skill. Or willpower.
Revelio. 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 Revelio!
Where did I set my traps? Was it lower Hogsfield or upper Hogsfield?
Revelio.
I'm going to enjoy this.
Wizard kind will submit to us once the war is over.
Somebody there!
Hello?
Revelio.
These rocks have seen better days.
Ravenia. Revelio. Ravenia. Ravelio.
My dream of making a better world for me.
Revelio. Revelio.
Oh, I'm going to enjoy this.
I know I heard something that time.
Ravenia.
Set my traps. Is it lower or upper Hogsfield?
Revelio.
This patrol is worthless.
Ravenia.
Most prominent in my family worked in the mines at one time or other.
How unfortunate for you.
Where you will fail.
Revelio.
Enjoy suffering, do you?
Rebellion.
You owe me galleons and you can't pay.
Revelio. Revelio. Ravenia.
An astronomy table should prove useful once the sun's down.
Such a look of fear in your eyes.
Somebody out there?
Ravenia. Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Pleased to see Arn has his belongings back. Ranrok, see if there's something you need. That's been a pleasure. Theophilus Harlow should have foreseen the repercussions of associating.
Thank you. Resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included. Revelio.
You can stop a thief in there.
Revelio.
Wonder who lives here.
Revelio. Revelio.
You can do
it. No!
Spill up!
So are all me lads in Rookwood Tormsy Glade.
Marlo never hurt anyone who didn't deserve it.
Crucio! Avada Kedavra! Revelio. Revelio.
Victor Rookwood is dead. He confronted me as I left Ollivander's with the Keeper's wand. I had to defend myself.
Godric's heart, are you all right? I know you're well able to defend yourself. I've seen it often enough. But Rookwood himself...
He destroyed so many lives and wouldn't have stopped. I'm glad I was able to put an end to him.
You're right. He wouldn't have stopped. You did what you had to do. With Harlow in custody and Rookwood gone, the wizarding community owes you a great debt.
Thank you for saying so, Professor. I'm ready for what's next.
All right, then. The Keepers have been waiting.
You have completed all of our trials, and you have done so under circumstances even I did not foresee. You understand now why all of this was necessary. The portkey, the vault, the locket, the book, the trials. To ensure that one with the ability you and I share would make the same choice that San, Neve, Charles, and I did.
Now that you have witnessed my memory, you understand all that is at stake. Not everyone is what they seem.
As you know, Light does not exist without shadow, nor shadow without light. Simply because you can eliminate darkness does not always mean that you should.
Even the most well-meaning and competent amongst us cannot possibly know the consequences of manipulating what should be beyond our reach.
What lies in the repository must never be released. Resist the temptation to destroy or control it. The magic that you have so carefully honed must now be used only to protect the secret we keep. You have the wand. You will know when to wield it. We leave our legacy in your hands.
We can only hope that we're not too late and that we find nothing but a repository undisturbed beyond this door.
I should hope that the enchantments protecting the castle will protect against an incursion from below.
I fear they may not. Although, if they don't now, I can assure you, they will in the future.
Were you able to reach Professor Weasley?
I was. Hopefully she and the others will arrive soon. They know where to find the door through which we entered. Damn, the goblins!
I wonder if Ranrok is here.
Let's go! If his loyalists are here, he cannot be far behind.
You and I have faced worse, Professor.
There's the area! Must be here somewhere!
We must be getting closer!
Ranrok will be pleased with our progress!
I don't know. I can only hope they arrive soon.
Let me observe.
wall. That's the way forward.
Very perceptive, Marie. It worked. Let's go.
Lumos!
Ranrok must be getting closer to finding the repository.
I fear you're right, Professor. There's nothing we can do but keep searching.
Lumos!
Listen, more goblins up ahead.
We're getting closer, Professor. That way.
Somehow evaded the castle's defensive charms.
Steer them this way! We shall make quick work of them!
Oh. They got this!
Who's in charge? Timing couldn't be better, Professor Hedwig.
Thank you, Professor.
believe we got here before Ranrok.
I can't believe this is it. The repository has been under the castle for hundreds of years.
Think of all the pain that created it. This is what Miriam, George, your friend Lodgok, and countless others died for. Miriam believed this forgotten magic could be used for such good. But she did not know the risks. She did not see what the Keepers have shown you. What Isadora showed you. You are now the Keeper of whatever power it holds. What do you intend to do with it?
I've decided to open the repository. Its power cannot lie dormant for centuries more.
After everything you've seen, what about Isadora's fate?
Isadora wasted her ability trying to save people from themselves. I will not let others dictate what I do with this. My power.
You cannot possibly mean that. You, of all wizard kind, are wholly aware of the misery and pain that that could cause.
The arrogance of wizard kind. Goblins built this repository. It belongs to us.
Enough, Ranrok. It was never yours.
I've been wanting to play with this.
Miriam's wand.
If she'd simply handed over the container, all of this could have been avoided. Foolish, self-important witch. Seems you were two of a kind. She didn't know when to give up either. Drink.
Have you now, Ranrok?
There seems to be some
hide now, Ravenclaw.
Eleazar Fig. I dare say he was a beloved professor to many of you, certainly a long-standing colleague to his peers. A famed adventurer and seeker of knowledge. He built a reputation charging into the unknown, brazenly disregarding both discretion and safety, providing perhaps a rather unfortunate lesson for us all. His devotion to adventure was rivaled only by his dedication to Hogwarts. And of course, to his wife, Midi, whom we lost much too soon as well.
Professor Fig represented the best of all of us. Oh, he could be deviously clever, possessed a brilliantly inquisitive mind, and was the most loyal of friends. But perhaps it was his remarkable courage, for which we will all be forever indebted to him. If not for Professor Fig, well, I can say with confidence that if not for him, many of us, let alone Hogwarts, would not be here today. Those that knew him best will agree that we must now honor him as only Hogwarts can, by wisely, resourcefully, justly, and bravely facing all that lies ahead.
To Professor Fig!
Never imagined we'd attend a funeral for one of our professors. Glad Weasley spoke for Fig. She honored him. He'll be well remembered. I only wish we could have done the same for Solomon Sallow. I need to go and see Anne soon.
Ominous, there's something I need to tell you. It's to do with Victor Rookwood.
I heard a rumor that he confronted you outside of Ollivander's. Sounds as if you faced quite a fight.
The rumor's true, and I did. But it's not that. Just before Rookwood attacked, he uttered something familiar. The same words Anne heard before she was cursed. Children should be seen and not heard.
Wait, what are you saying?
It wasn't one of Ranrok's loyalists who cursed Anne. It was Victor Rookwood. It was Rookwood all along.
This can't be. The night Anne was cursed, all she saw were goblins.
You see, since Feldcroft was of interest to Ranrok, it became of interest to Rookwood as well. That's why Rookwood was there the night Anne was cursed. He was working with Ranrok. When he saw Anne, well, he didn't want anyone to know that.
So he cursed her. Oh, so cruel. Rookwood got what he deserved. Thank you for telling me. Anne and Sebastian deserve to know, and it should come from me. As we discussed, I spoke with Black. Sebastian's with the headmaster now, but perhaps there's a way to get word to him. When I find out, I'll send an owl.
I have news about Sebastian. Meet me in the Undercroft as soon as you can.
Off on another adventure, are we?
So Hogwarts lives on, free of the goblin menace.
Thank you for coming.
Ominous, I received your owl. What's happened with Sebastian?
He's been expelled, and will soon face trial at the Ministry. Although Anne wanted to turn him in, I think now she's torn. I confess I know how she feels. As much as we all wanted Sebastian to face the consequences of his actions, it will never be the same without him. Just standing here in the Undercroft without Sebastian feels wrong.
Sebastian brought all of this on himself. We tried and tried to stop him.
We did. I just wish things had turned out differently.
Were you able to tell Sebastian about Rookwood cursing Anne?
I was. Black let me talk to Sebastian before he left. At first he wouldn't believe it. Then he realized it all made sense. Unfortunately, his anger only grew towards goblins and dark wizards. Anne was shocked too. but in some sense relieved to know the truth about who was responsible. I think it brought her some peace.
I'm glad to hear it. She deserves peace.
She does. Sebastian was my best friend. I can't imagine Hogwarts or anywhere without him. I know you two had grown close, that you were helping each other with more than just finding a cure for Anne. He never gave specifics, but I know it was important. He means a lot to us both. I hope we get the chance to tell him that one day. I know we had a bit of a rocky start, but you've proven yourself as a friend. I'm glad you came to Hogwarts.
Thank you.
Heard you and Sebastian traversed a mountain in loyalist territory. You know, that sort of thing could have got you both killed.
Uncle Roland sends his best. He often asks after you and his owls.
Professor Weasley, you wanted to see me?
I did. We haven't had a chance to speak since I know you were quite close with Professor Fig.
Hogwarts won't be the same without him.
No, it won't. But I can assure you that he would want us to press on, and that he would rest easy knowing that the future of the wizarding world is in hands like yours.
Thank you, Professor.
You've had quite a year, both inside and outside of Hogwarts. I've heard all sorts of rumors. You've ridden a graphorn, befriended a goblin, rescued hippogriffs, even helped Mr. Ollivander track down a family wand.
How did you...
It's harder to keep secrets around here than one might suspect. I'm just glad you found such a good friend in Miss Sweeting. It's nice to see her engaging more with her classmates. There have evidently been Snidget sightings in the area lately. If the centaurs are to be believed, two Hogwarts students are behind it.
I'm certain I don't know what...
No need to discuss it further. What I would like to discuss is your wizard's field guide. May I see it?
Of course. What do you think, Professor?
I think you've been busy this year. It seems you've nothing left to do to complete your field guide. Most impressive! With your OWLs soon upon us, I am thrilled to see you so prepared. I will confess, I had a sense about you from that first moment you came bursting in, late, to the sorting ceremony. I am pleased to see that my instincts were correct. To think you've only been with us a year and you'll already be taking your OWLs, well, it's nothing short of astonishing.
Thank you, Professor, for everything.
You are most welcome. I look forward to seeing what you do during the rest of your time with us.
I almost bought an owl in Diagon Alley.
Oh no, Sir Fitzroy! My turn!
Puffskeen Dunkeen is still all I hear. Thanks for being an utter waste of time.
Thank you.
This year, we have seen our students exemplify the bravery of Godric Gryffindor. Allow me to finish. The loyalty of Helga Hufflepuff. The wisdom of Rowena Ravenclaw. And the ambition of Salazar Slytherin. And so, the winner of this year's House Cup...
Excuse me, Headmaster, if I may. One particular student's heroism during the attack on Hogwarts, not to mention the level to which they have excelled in their coursework, as a new student, no less. Well, it would seem that it certainly merits, I'd say, 100 points to their house. Wouldn't you agree?
Ah, yes. Thank you, Professor Weasley. I suppose we have our winner.